Have you ever been shocked? You walk across carpet and you touch a doorknob. Or somebody walks up to you and they touches you. You can feel and hear it, and sometimes you can even see it. And this is from static electricity. Now, let's do some experiments with static electricity before we explain what it is. Okay, so you're gonna want to blow up a balloon, and then you're gonna rub it back and forth through your hair. But you want your hair dry, and you don't want any hair products in it. And you're just gonna rub it in your hair like this. And notice how the hair sticks to the balloon? So when you rub the balloon on your hair, the balloon is stealing electrons from your hair. And since electrons are negative, then the hair is losing that negative and it becomes slightly positive. And since the balloon is taking that negative, it is becoming slightly negative. And just like a magnet, opposites attract, so the slightly positive hair will stick to the slightly negative balloon. Naturally, most things are slightly positive, so they're going to be attracted to anything that is negative.
Water, like most things, are slightly positive. And yes, here I go again talking about water, but this is a really neat trick. So get a thin, steady stream of water going from the sink, rub the balloon in your hair, and slowly bring the balloon closer to the stream of water. Now, you can do that with a comb as well. You would just brush the comb through your hair at least 10 times. As you can see, it gets a little bit staticky because the comb, just like the balloon, is stealing the electrons from your hair. And the comb is becoming negative and the hair is becoming positive. So they're a little bit attracted to each other. And that's why your hair gets a little staticky after you brush it. So you know that opposites attract. But if you were to rub two balloons in your hair and tried bringing them together, what do you think would happen? Would they still attract to each other? Let's find out. Again, make sure you get it really good. And it's sticking. Okay, let's see what happens.
And you can try this with different objects found around your home. Just make sure that the object is on a smooth surface and rub the balloon in your hair. And then see if it attracts the object or repels the object.
So the positive wants to find the negative, and it's going to pull each other in so that they can balance. They're going to transfer their charge until they're the same. But two things with the same charge, they're going to push each other away. A negative doesn't want to touch another negative because it wants to be positive, not more negative. So as you can tell, static electricity is from an imbalance of charges, meaning that one thing is more negative and one thing is more positive. And since the universe likes balance and order, it's going to try to attract things of the opposite charge so that they can balance each other out. And this happens instantly. And that's that shock that you feel and hear and can see. And this is called electrical discharge, where the charges are balancing each other. And if you've ever been shocked by something electrical, well, it's the same thing. It's just more powerful because there's a lot more energy being transferred. And lightning is the same thing. A charge is being transferred from the clouds in the sky to the ground here on Earth. It's transferring their charge so that they can be balanced. And this happens very quickly. But it's the same concept as when we're shocked. But it's a much larger shock because it's much larger energy being transferred. And this is making thunder and lightning. Pretty cool, right? Well, emotions can work the same way. When you're having a bad day, it's very noticeable. And that negative energy can transfer to someone else. It's very contagious. And if you're having a bad day, you can rub off on someone else and make them have a bad day. And it's the same for when you're having a good day. That good attitude can be contagious and it can rub off on someone else who's having a bad day. And you can make their day better. That positive attitude, just like a positive charge, can be transferred. But this time, there's no shock. And you don't have to lose any of your positive attitude in order to share it with the people around you. Attitudes are extremely contagious, and you can make someone else's day better. And for the people that are around you, the more that they feel good and feel positive, the easier it will be for you to stay positive and feel good.
So what are you guys struggling with this week? Is there anything or anyone that you guys want me to pray for?
So go out there, smile, make others feel good, and be happy. And until next time, bye!